Master has banned Collector in all four matches. Log is a ban from Sergio Ramos, ideally, I assume, targeting Expo and some other things. This is an incredible match between two players. They both played 7 games. Sergio Ramos has played 6 different decks in 7 games. Music Master has played 5 different decks in 7 games. Both incredibly diverse and skillful players. Each with 2-1 victories in the semifinal stage. It was not a crushing defeat for their opponents by any means. Anyone can take this crown. It's all up to them to show us if they've got the stuff of stars. And make that 6 different decks for Music Master as he has switched it up with a what? Mega Knight Hog Rider deck.
What has happened? Sergio Ramos is being torn apart on the left lane. Ran out of elixir and a massive connection from Music Master has taken him down to triple digits in the very first minute of this game.
Music Master, now this is a match between a world divided. We saw all those predictions. I looked on Twitter between this matchup and get this, everyone in every poll in the Western Hemisphere has Sergio Ramos winning. Every poll in the Eastern Hemisphere has Music Master
wow.
winning. I swear, this is an incredible matchup between two players. The world cannot decide on who the favorite is. Goblin Hut in the middle will start producing Spear Goblins to try to chip away Sergio Ramos's tower. He fell behind early, but we are about 30 seconds away from double elixir time. Music Master gets out a second spawn building, and he's looking to pressure that left lane for the rest of the game.
Mine are a good counter. We're going to chip away at that furnace a little bit, but the Ice Spirit buys a little bit of time for the next wave of Fire Spirits to come out. Takes him down. It's still 1670, a relatively healthy left side tower for Music Master. A minute and 14 left until this game is going to be over, but double elixir time starts soon. Which deck do you think has the advantage in that time?
I gotta say, Music Master's double spawner deck. When you are gaining elixir that quickly and you are able to put down just Furnace and Goblin Hut and get multiples of them out throughout the game, you're in good shape. But oh no! Triple digits by far as Sergio Ramos catches up and has taken the damage advantage as we at the start of double elixir time.
Heavy punished by Sergio Ramos. Saw that Mega Knight way far in the back and thought, now's my time to strike. Sent in a great little push that did a ton of damage.
Is he gonna get the jump?
Oh,
no!
Getting awfully close, he might get...
Oh!
If he had jumped right on top of the Electro Wizard.
If he had landed, that would be a totally different game. Cannon Car takes out the Electro Wizard, is beginning to pressure the tower. Tesla Tower coming down.
No, pushed back by the Goblins. Ooh. Awfully close, but no cigar this time. Sergio Ramos behind in damage, but not by much.
Flying Machine played too far up. It was meant to turn around and shoot the Miner first. It didn't get there, and instead it's locked on to the Knight. But Poison will get that damage down a little lower. We're getting into overtime very soon. Even though there's a little bit of a lead for Music Master, they're both so low that the first tower to go down will put you up one battle at this best of five matchup.
Cannon Card out the left side for Music Master, playing cool on defense. There's not a big win condition from Sergio Ramos. All he could really have to do is throw that Miner in there, so he's got to play smart defense and try to get a massive attack in there. Not looking likely, though, as Music Master with a huge push, Mega Knight to pulverize the defense. Tesla goes down, and we've got a strong, healthy Flying Machine getting awfully close. Poison ticks that tower down to 146. Rumham, it looks like it's almost over.
Two cards, I'm counting out Music Master cycle. Two cards there, three cards, and gets
the
Ice Master takes the first battle. Oh my, the Cannon Card snuck by and took battle number one. Music Master, just 2 games, 6 minutes away from being the first world champion. Can Sergio Ramos tie it up as we head into battle two?
Woo, Woody,
what's your thoughts on that? This double spawner deck, this is the new hotness. This is the new trend.
It definitely is. They've shown us time and time again how much value you can get out of the combo of Spear Goblins and Fire Spirits. It's a good bit of swarm that can be built up if your opponent sends in a troop that's too big. If you can get a nice wave of Spear Goblins all backed up with that great splash damage, there's hardly anything that your opponent
right.
can do to really shut that down in an elixir-efficient way. We saw Miners going in, Poisons being dropped on those spawners, but ultimately, Music Master, especially with that nice early hit that he got, definitely pulled far ahead in that game. Almost got a turnaround there for Sergio Ramos with the punish when that Mega Knight came down in the back from Music Master, but with just enough time at the end, one final shot from the Cannon Cart, and it was curtains.
The double spawner deck has lost only one game in this entire tournament, and it was quiet against Tali. Other than that, Music Master hasn't lost with it. He's played it 3 times. He's played it in almost every single match except for the semifinals where he ended up not playing it. But he's played in every other match, and it's won every single time. He may just stick with it. Now, we saw something like this very similarly in the North American region. Once he got on a deck, he just kind of kept playing it until his opponent could show that he could beat it. But in the very first round, he lost by playing Mega Knight Balloon 2 times in a row. So he said, it was a mistake. I probably shouldn't have done that. So I would expect him to change decks. But this double spawner deck has been so powerful, and at at this 11th hour, it's really hard to learn how to counter it because you don't have time to practice against it. It was revealed just a couple hours ago.
Exactly. The creativity and knowing how to build something like that and then piloting it to victory against the best players in the world, it's really shown that it takes a lot of skill and understanding of all 70 whatever cards that have been released in the game to be able to tear apart that sort of creative deck building skill.
Ooh, it looks like Music Master's opening with another Goblin Hunt. I assume it's the same deck, but of course it could be maybe like the Lupanji Pekka Mega Knight deck. This might even be an evolution of that deck. No, Double Spawner's coming out again. So can Sergio Ramos beat it? This time, though, he has a Miner to get in there and actually aggro.
Well, and the Mega Mains get all the way close to the tower. They're well played.
Wow, what coming in from Music Master as he recognizes a big hit from Sergio is coming down on the right side.
Sergio pulled off an excellent bamboozle there, pulling the cannon card in. Yeah, two trick, two, six elixir really worth of troops were pulled back behind the tower, and that allowed the Mega Minion to connect. Golem's coming down for Sergio Ramos, and Golem, an excellent card at dealing with spawner buildings. It's heavy enough that it can just muscle through them.
Not the sort of card you'd expect this early in the game, but a great way to shut down that cannon card push, and with plenty of help on those minions, he's gonna be able to teleport the flying machine. Backside poison's looking awfully good as well, as a Golem is connected and tears apart that right side tower. Minions and attaché have done their job. Sergio Ramos with the 1-0 lead over Music Master in this second battle.
And not just a 1-0 lead, but both of his towers are as healthy as they can really be. I think he's just got to play defense for the next minute 30. Music Master, though, smiled, kind of gave a nod, said, well played. Here's the thing. Music Master's been banning Elixir Collector all the time. I think he's written off Golem as a deck that he would see. Sergio Ramos said, you know what? Like, if you're going to sit back and just play spawner buildings, fine, then I'll play Golem in the same lane as it, and it seems very effective.
Clutch flying machine from Music Master tears apart that poor furnace, and it's looking like even though he's got the defensive edge with that King Tower up, he hasn't managed to be able to chip into Sergio Ramos once again. Music Master doesn't really have a super heavy win condition here. It's more of a mid-range deck, and especially going up against Golem, it's going to be super difficult for that Mega Knight to ever even get a chance to hit the tower.
And with poison in Sergio Ramos' deck being really good, not just against hitting the tower and the spawner buildings, but if you can catch a flying machine in that as well, very quickly you can get a huge damage lead. That Inferno Dragon, eats up Mega Knight in record time. Zap was out of cycle.
Caution. Electro Wizard not in the arena. Inferno Dragon going wild.
Now the shield break on the cannon card actually does reset the Inferno Dragon, so they've gave it a chance, slowed it down, allowed it to die to the tower. You're seeing Mega Knight coming in the other lane, looks like he's trying to go for kind of an all-in attack here. Great Ice Spear, no, it jumps on the Miner instead, allowing the Inferno Dragon to take it down, and I think that was Music Master's last chance in this game. With just 17 seconds to go, Sergio Ramos is holding strong in both lanes, and he is going to tie this matchup 1-1.
10 seconds left, and Music Master is showing his hand. Nothing that he can do at this point. As time whittles away, Sergio Ramos offers the good game, and we are going into battle number 3, Ramham.
This is incredible. Almost the only time Music Master has lost is when he's played the same deck twice. So if he switches up decks, he's good at catching people off guard, making predictions about what his opponents are going to play. But when he sticks to the same deck, he's gotten countered. Happened in the first round and has happened here in game 2 of the finals. Great news, though. Best of 5, not best of 3. So we're going to let this play out a little more and get to a true, undisputed champion.
Absolutely. Single elim means that all we can really say is the number one player will have the crown at the very end. Best of 5 is the best way to make sure that you are so skilled with so many different types of decks, but also that there's no, you know, hiccups in there. It's not just going to be losing a few rounds that gets you kicked out. You got to take 3 losses in order to be eliminated at this point. Best of 5 means that these guys have got a long way left to go before they can claim that crown, Ramham.
And this is just, there's so much to say. We have 2 young players just qualified for the Crown Championship Global Series this year. They really both made their regional finals just in the fall, right? They weren't here in the spring season as well. And here they are meeting, and the ultimate prize between them. Nova versus Sandstorm, Music Master versus Sergio Ramos, USA versus Mexico. It is so easy to pick a side if you have an opinion on things.
I have an opinion on things, but I'm gonna let the viewers decide for their own. Let us know in chat if you are on Music Master's side or if you're rooting for Sergio Ramos.
And Twitter is alight with people saying, you know, go, go, go to their favorite players. Knight comes down just in time to block the bandit, and the bandit is going to be held there. And I think Knight is even going to do a great job at distracting anything the goblin tries to come down. You know, you can be able to handle as well. Oh, there you go. Minions get held off. Now, there's no log, remember. So both players actually, a spell bait, it might look a whole lot better in a world without log, but those minions want to get a rock
on him. Right side takes 500 damage, and it's a relative draw at this point. Highway robbery not taking place as the bandit went down, but Sergio Romer's countless attacks from the skies.
Another bandit dash! Wow, the knight was not in cycle that time, and the goblins are going to get a little more damage, bringing it down to just poison, oh, I can't say log, but a little more than like a minor poison. We'll take that tower down on the right.
Grand Theft Tower, great dash by the bandit. She steals not only hearts, but also wins. Sergio Ramos up, and what is that?
That is Music Master's Mortar. Mortar Master, some call him. Now, I don't really like that placement, though, because the poison is like, of course he'd want to poison that side, but look at that, he just used poison, and instead Mortar is going to get shot after shot after shot.
Punishing the poison, though, he sends in the minion horde. No spell in Sergio Ramos' deck to deal with it, but pulled away by goblins.
Well played, though, is given out. The minions, though, connect on the other side, and they're going to shred that tower for a ton of damage. No bad princess.
Wow.
She gets dashed on by the bandit, and the minions are going to finish off that right side tower. 1 minute and 10 seconds left, and Sergio Ramos is again up a tower.
Music Master gives up his right side. He's ready to continue the siege, though. He could actually go left or right at this point. Going for that right side tower of Sergio Ramos would be a little bit more difficult just because he's lost his right side tower already. Wow, the eighth card in Sergio's deck, though, is not good news for Music Master. Pekka is a master of destruction.
And the timing could not hurt more just as the mortar comes out. You see it. Oh, is poison going to come out? Is he saving up for it? The Electro Wizard gets cleaned up, and the princess takes it out. She's going to be shooting on the tower, but no, bandit's going to come clean her out. Still, though, both of Sergio Ramos' towers are not looking very good.
Pekka's got the tower down! 3 swings, and it is finished off with the fourth. Sergio Ramos with the 2-0 lead.
And Pekka, minor control, is putting Sergio Ramos in the lead in this match with a 3-crown victory, maybe? I don't know. Well, hold on. Oh, there it is. Woo. Music Master gave me a little bit of a heart attack there for a second, but Sergio does take the 3-crown. He's up 2-1 in this match, just 3 minutes away from being the first ever Clash Royale World Champion.
The 3-crown and down. That's one of the first 3 crowns we've seen today. Not many had happened by any means. And what a devastating attack Sergio Ramos was able to put together there. And with a smile, too.
Think how stressful it must be for those players standing on the stage, not just looking across at your foe, but looking at the thousands in attendance. And on top of that, both of their parents are here watching. Can you imagine how stressful it is for the parents, unable to help, unable to do anything, not exactly sure what's happening on the screen? Like, there's so much going on for them, and we have at most 2, but maybe just 1 more battle left before we know who the best Clash Royale player in the world is, from 28 million down to just 1.
It was all up in the air at the beginning of the day, Rumham, but we've taken the 16 best players in the world, and we now have whittled it down to 2. Team Sandstorm behind now. Music Master trying to take this for the US of A, but Sergio Ramos, one of the youngest players, has some of the most experience in these types of circumstances. Can he get the win for Mexico and Team Nova?
And Music Master once again goes with Mortar, but early on, Bandit and Minions are going to counter it.
Dang.
7 Elixir for Music Master, 6 for Sergio Ramos, and I think he got the better end of that exchange.
Did. Sergio a little bit ahead, but not by a whole lot. They're just feeling each other's decks out right now, getting a sense for what they're up against. Nice zap from Sergio, though. Get some value from this Miner.
1 more card, and Music Master will be back to Mortar, so maybe he can try that again. I do like opening with Mortar, just like opening with Hog Rider. If they don't have a counter to it, then you can get a ton of value in the first 15 seconds or so of the game.
Oh, interesting counter. We got the minion horde coming out in from Music Master. Could leave him with an opportunity to counterattack, and he can send that
interesting choice.
Even with something, but not looking like that. I thought he'd be able to drop a knight in there.
He did have
the
knight
bandit
in cycle.
Yeah.
I'm kind of surprised he went with that. Maybe he thought between the bandit charge and the electro wizard attack, the knight would go down in record time, and it would not be a very good defense. Once again, though, miner's coming down. Oh, no, this mortar's not going to hit. Zap takes it out again. Princess providing some support damage, but I think those minions are even going to close in and maybe get some damage on the tower. No.
Miner even did a great job blocking for the princess out in the left side. Locked on to the mortar over there. They were tearing through that thing. No value for that siege emplacement as Music Master struggles to find an inroad in this fourth battle of what might be the last in this match from him.
Music Master did again. He played the same deck two games in a row. He's playing Mortar the second time, and looks like he's got the same matchup against Pekka Minor. So one of those last two cards, I believe, is Poison, the other being Minor. Very scary to deal with. We'll have to see if he can bait maybe out the Poison.
There it goes.
It's on the Minion Horde, though, which is not really what you're looking for. Now he can play Minion Horde, but it's out of Cyclades, so it's out of his hand.
Killer Strike from Sergio Ramos as he has not much to fear in this final minute of the battle. Music Master defending against Goblins now with a Princess. Gets a little bit of chip damage in there, but takes two stabs.
Now the Princess is there to support. Pekka comes down to block, but if he can take out this Pekka and keep the Mortar standing, there is a very good chance that he can turn this around and take the tower.
Soaks the bandit damage up the left side, and I agree with that. You gotta be able to take a one on the chin if you're gonna invest your elixir in defense of the right. He's going in hard, trying to tear that tower down with a good Mortar lock, but the Pekka takes short work of it, chopping it out the back as the Miner goes in to support some minions, but once again, rebuffed. Sergio Ramos has so many spells, and the Electro Wizard on top, he doesn't have to worry very much at all about these swarm attacks from Music Master.
Over and over again, Sergio Ramos, whose zap and his poison are MVPs in this game, zapping the bats, poisoning the Minion Horde. Both of them are great traits that are putting him ahead. He only needs another minor poison attack or so in order to take this game. And because Music Master knows that, he's going with an aggressive attack to bait the poison out. There goes Electro Wizard trying to stop it. Electro Wizard will start the counterattack on the other side. But now both of Music Master's towers are low. Sergio Ramos is sweating, wiping the sweat from his brow because he knows he's just 274 damage away from being the next victor. He needs to poison it. He needs to zap it. Sergio Ramos, the world championship is in your grip.
The finishing kill there. Minion Horde at the right side to defend, but the poison will take it down, and that's the last chance that Music Master has to strike. No Mortar for him to lock on at this point, and the minions are going to be able to stab down this Miner. I don't think that there's anything left for Sergio to do but send in the final blow, Ramam.
He's just got to cycle back. Zap lowers it. He needs the poison. He's played one card, two cards. I think just two more cards will bring him the poison and the victory. Sergio Ramos from Mexico is going to be your first ever Clash Royale champion.
The bandit takes it. Sergio Ramos wins. First place in the Clash Royale Cloud Championship World Finals goes to the Nova player from Mexico.
He can't stand. He's holding on to the flag. He cannot believe it. Just hours ago, he was the biggest underdog in this field, and now you can call him the first ever Clash Royale World Champion. Nova, he has come this far, defeating player after player. He has played Giant Beatdown, Three Musketeer, Graveyard, Pekka, and more Minor Poison and Pekka Control. Deliver it to him as Nova rushes the stage. You can see his coach, his teammates, the owner of Nova, all hugging him. They have done it. They have come so far and played so hard. And you can count Nova as the first team and Sergio Ramos, the first player to crown the world champion.